From the first day that we started WeWork, it was about bringing people together. There's an energy that you feel.
If you are well-versed with the startup world, you probably know all about WeWork. You might even be sitting in one of WeWork's many branches worldwide. You might have also heard about the company nearly going bankrupt after putting out a valuation of $47 billion. Today, we're going to be talking about WeWork's IPO disaster. Stay tuned until the end to find out what was the cause of WeWork's downfall. This is Fraud Explained. To enjoy more videos, subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell, or else I'll be looking into you too. WeWork, known officially as the We Company, was founded in 2010, and its growth was so instantaneous, people all over the globe were amazed. It positioned itself as a co-working space that people would be able to rent and work in. Not long after its first few branches opened, WeWork expanded to 836 other locations. It immediately hired over 50,000 employees and took on over 500,000 members to use its facilities. Things seemed to be looking up for WeWork until the mid-2019s. Suddenly, WeWork plummeted. Let's dive into WeWork's story. In the middle of the year 2019, the company filed the papers they needed to be able to prepare for an initial public offering, which would allow them to begin trading in the stock market. Up until that point, people were kept in the dark with just how WeWork was making its money and why it was valued so high. However, their initial public offering required WeWork to publish how they were doing financially. That's when people became suspicious. Once everyone was able to take a peek at the brand's financials, everyone quickly caught on that the WeWork they were being sold was not really what it claimed to be. Not only was the company not profitable, but its CEO, Adam Neumann, was living such a luxurious lifestyle and was bleeding the company dry. As a result, Adam Neumann got ousted from his position. However, the valuation of WeWork went from a whopping $47 billion to roughly $8 billion within a matter of days. SoftBank, WeWork's lead investor, finally had to step in to rescue the company from shutting down completely. Before we go deeper into that, let's take a look at the life of the CEO in question, Adam Neumann. Adam Neumann was born on April 25th, 1979, in Tel Aviv, Israel. The Neumann family is from Israel and are of Jewish descent. When Neumann was just 7 years old, his parents Avivit and Doron Neumann went through a divorce. After this, he and his younger sister, Adi, moved to the United States with their mother, who went to America to pursue her medical residency. As a child, Adam Neumann suffered from severe dyslexia. He was unable to read or write until the third grade. In 1990, after spending 4 years in the United States, the family returned to Israel and settled in Kibbutz Nir Am. Adam Neumann then served for 5 years in the Israeli Navy. He later attended the Siklin School of Business at Baruch College in New York City. Before founding WeWork, Neumann founded a children's clothing company called Crawlers, where he specialized in manufacturing baby clothes with knee pads. However, he wanted to venture into other areas of business, and so he did. Adam Neumann met his partner Miguel McKelvey through a mutual friend, and the two began working together. Their shared interests in community upbringings and design led them to create Green Desk in 2008. They laid out more or less 100 spaces and rented them out from $350 to $2,400 a month. The business picked up and it seemed that everything was going pretty well. After a while, Adam Neumann and Miguel McKelvey sold Green Desk and used the funds to start a new space in Soho in 2010. Green Desk served as a precursor to their new space. They called the space WeWork. Adam began to raise funds to be able to support their brand new endeavor. He was quite skilled at it. However, pretty soon things would take a dark turn. Keep watching to find out what happened. Manhattan prime property owner Joel Schreiber was one of WeWork's major investors. He invested $15 million in the company and was a stakeholder of around 33% of the company. At this point, WeWork was already valued at around $45 million. It was not really known exactly how well WeWork was doing or how many people patronized the brand, but for a company that was just starting out, $45 million is already quite high for a startup company's valuation. When Joel Schreiber was asked about his dealings with Adam Neumann, he only had this to say. I did negotiate. I said yes. I love Adam's energy. Fast forward a few years later in 2014, WeWork was already considered to be the fastest growing lease company space in New York. Forbes also took note of the brand's sudden growth. In that year alone, WeWork expected to earn around $150 million and $400 million a year after that. New locations were launching with 80% occupancy. They bragged to the press about their operating margin, which was, at the time, 30%. Major financial institutions like JP Morgan and powerful wealthy individuals like Mort Zuckerman also invested in the company, which allowed it to receive a whopping $150 million worth of funds. This funding led the company to grow even further, and it was soon valued at $1.5 billion. WeWork was also charging its clients around $650 a month per person for a desk, which meant they had to be earning considerably well. Now, what happened to WeWork? Well, let's just say it's the classic example of what happens when a company gets too much money too fast and it does not take any measures towards spending it wisely. As WeWork is no longer one of the leading names in the market, the company is only going to get smaller and smaller and may never grow as big as it initially had. During the summer of 2019, WeWork was considered to be one of the most valuable startups in the world, with a valuation of roughly $47 billion. It had a higher value than companies like Airbnb, Stripe, and SpaceX. However, in just a few months' time, the shine wore off of WeWork, and its value plummeted drastically. The company went from a valuation of $47 billion to near bankruptcy, all within a span of 6 weeks. Basically, an initial public offering is put out in order to get investors to fund your company so that you may be able to gain more money to grow. It happens when the company seeks to raise additional funding from new investors, and the shares are offered publicly. On August 14, 2019, WeWork released its S-1 filings. Since WeWork seemed like such a promising company, many investors were interested and wanted it. However, when they were finally able to see the numbers and analyze WeWork's financials, everyone began to realize how much they stood to lose if they bet on a company like WeWork. Contrary to what it positioned itself as, WeWork was actually not a tech company. In 2018, it generated $1.8 billion in revenue, but spent double that amount, a whopping total of $3.7 billion. They recorded losses of roughly $2 billion. During the first half of 2019, WeWork also recorded losses of over $900 million, which showed that it was an extremely unprofitable venture. The IPO was a drastic move for the company to earn more money. It desperately needed to earn funds from the IPO to continue its operation, or it would go completely bankrupt. Controversies and scandals regarding Adam Neumann's role as WeWork's CEO began to circulate. Investors were no longer interested in investing in WeWork, as they did not trust the brand. Adam Neumann was the captain of a sinking ship. On September 22, 2019, there were reports from news outlets stating that various WeWork directors were planning on asking Neumann to step down as the company's CEO after a tumultuous week in which his eccentric behavior and drug use came to light, just a short time before a planned initial public offering. Adam Neumann had always dreamed of being filthy rich. He would always tell investors that he had the personal goal of becoming the world's first trillionaire. With his charm and wit, Adam convinced the board to buy him a private jet to use to travel around the world. Neumann purchased $90 million worth of homes, including a 60-acre estate in Westchester County, New York, a 6,000-square-foot condominium near Gramercy Park, two mansions in the Hamptons, and a $21 million mansion in Corte Madera, California. On top of all that, Adam Neumann borrowed over a whopping $740 million against his own stock. He even sold a lot of his own shares in the company, which raised suspicion against him even more. The IPO intention was then withdrawn by the company, and major layoffs were announced by October 3rd. Over 4,000 employees were facing unemployment, and branches worldwide threatened to close down. WeWork had lost the trust of its investors. However, it was also running out of money, fast. Drastic measures needed to be done in order to save the company. WeWork had no choice but to seek profitability as a real estate company that it always really was, in spite of promoting itself as a tech startup. On September 24, 2019, Adam Neumann finally resigned, and Artie Minson and Sebastian Gunningham were instated as co-successors. In October 2019, Neumann was reported to receive somewhere around $1.7 billion from one of WeWork's major stakeholders, SoftBank, for stepping down as WeWork's CEO. He was also required to cut ties with the majority of the company. After stepping down, Neumann was also slapped with lawsuits from minor shareholders for how badly he had mismanaged the company. According to David Trainer, a contributor at Forbes, WeWork might not be the largest IPO of 2019, but it is easily the most ridiculous and the most dangerous. Other big money IPOs during the last few years had something tangible to show. They offered legitimate innovation in their business models. Unlike WeWork, that pretended to be a tech startup and trick investors to put their money into the company, even if it did not have much to show for it. According to Trainer, WeWork also burns tons of cash, carries huge risk factors in a recession, and sports some of the worst corporate governance practices I've ever seen. WeWork is in the danger zone. Beneath WeWork's shiny exterior of posing as a successful company lay the not-so-pretty truth. For a while, WeWork was just a company that overvalued itself and was hailed as one of the best companies in the business, when it really had not proved much yet. To make matters worse, it was led by a money-hungry CEO who was drunk on his own ambition and focused more on his image instead of making sure that the company was in good hands. What are your thoughts on WeWork's $47 billion IPO disaster? What could Neumann have done to prevent losing the trust of his investors? Let's talk about it in the comments section below. We'll be responding to all of you who comment within the first hour. If you like this video, you should check out our other video on the rise and fall of Kraft Heinz to see the story behind one of the world's most beloved brands. Stay tuned and stay educated.